स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हाउ पीपल्स दे सेटल्ड इन परमानेंट प्लेस इन इंडिया. सो दीज आर द मैटर्स एंड व्हाट वाज द एविडेंस वी गॉट. सो दीज आर सम मैटर्स वी डिस्कस्ड इन लास्ट सेशन. सो इन दिस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट, वी गॉट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट वन ऑफ द न्यू विलेज, अ न्यू साइट. वी गॉट द एविडेंस एज ए सिविलाइजेशन, मीन्स पीपल्स दे लिव एज ए ग्रुप. Like in village in peoples they're living, that lake we got the evidence, people they settled in a one particular place. We got some of the site means we got some of the evidence about the constructions of house or any other matters. So these are the informations we are discussing in this session. Okay, now first of all, when engineers after the independence, in 1902, in that time when the engineers they start one of the new railway link in Sindh region, in river Sindh region in North India, when they started to new railway link, and that time they observed when they constructed to start the railway link, they got some of the source, means some of the bricks, that also burnt bricks. Is very hard bricks. So when they got this one, they used that only bricks and they constructed by railway link in that time. So when this lack of incident is happened, archaeologists, they see the constructed railway links, they used as a bricks. So now one question is arised, how this one bricks is came in that place? Because want to made it that one bricks, without that one we cannot get the bricks, we all are knowing that one. So on this based archaeologist or Indian government or on the time who are there in British peoples, they observe these are the matters and they thought that we want to research about this one, how this one bricks came in this place in Sindh region. So when they started research, not only in that place, when they started surrounding area, when they started to research, they got so much of that like of bricks, so much of sites. So when they got this like of site, they thought that this is not a naturally, this is not came, this is one of the important civilization peoples they live in ancient time in this place, because they got so much of site, so much of bricks, all are burnt bricks, and they got so much of houses also. When they excavated, when they started to research about in that place, so they got some of the site. So on this base they written in history archaeologist, here we can find one of the new civilization, a new city, a new area, new site, and they given name as a Harappa civilization. So in this way peoples, means archaeologists, they thought that in 4600 years ago peoples they settled in India, especially in Harappa, where they constructed in railway link or railway line. In that place when they got the bricks, on this based archaeologists they written in history, peoples they settled in this region and they used to construct for bricks, and they constructed house based on the bricks, that also burnt bricks, that only they used. So on this based archaeologists or historians they started to write the history. So on this based now we want to discuss not only this one. Archaeologists they written in history that also this is not a like a this like a village like of not a civilization, this is urbanized civilization. Why we calling urbanized civilization? Because of what they got the evidence, all are like a systematic. Now we are discussing next session that only why that one calling as a systematic, because of they constructed house like systematic, and road or drainage system, or the lifestyle of peoples, all are systematic. So on this based archaeologists they return this is not a like a other like of civilization, not this is urbanized civilization. People, they know how to live, how to construct the buildings, how to construct the roads. They all are knowing, and they knowing we want to build the house, we can use that one for burnt bricks. They understood the knowledge, they got the knowledge, technology. So on this base they built the city. So that's why archaeologists, they written in history, Harappa civilization is urbanized. So now we want to discuss what was the special features we can find out in that civilization. Why we called as urbanized civilization for this one Harappa civilization? That only we are discussing. So when the archaeologists, when they started to research in that place, in Harappa place, when they started to research, they divided as a two part in Harappa civilization based on the structure. Based on the physical structure, they divided as a two part. One is they given western part. This is a very narrow, and this is in above height. Like in mountains, in that place we can see this like a part. This is one part. And they say, archaeologists, they call this is a fort. This is fort. Where they got evidence in Harappa civilization, if they got that one evidence in mountains, so they called, they give a name as a, this is fort in Harappa civilization. And in down, next one part here they say, that is in eastern part, that is very wide, and next they say, and this one is, if you are comparing to the western part, this is very lower level. Level is very low. So on this base they written in history, or in archaeologists they researched and they written in history, what they written, this is village, means people they living in this place. In western part, that is fort, eastern part, that is low level village. So these like they written in history, and they say every part, that western part or eastern part, every part they constructed, they built, means they used only burnt bricks. This is one of the special features, fort as well as low level of village. Both also they constructed and they used burnt bricks. In that only they made. So this is also one of the important features. And here they say that burnt bricks, how they constructed or how they built that one cities or area, that also interlocking system, each by each interlocking system. We are now interlock. What is meant by interlock? So that like of systems in, they built by bricks. So just you have to imagine it, how much of knowledge they knowing the peoples in ancient time. So this is also one of the important features. And that walls, what they built, that walls, that one house walls, this is very strong. This is also one of the important feature, because they did that in interlock. The burnt bricks they did in interlock, so that's why wall is very strong. And next one features here they say, and inside that one building we can see the fort. Not only fort, here they say Mohenjo-daro, one of the important city, in that place they got the water tank. You can see that one image in page number 14 also, you can see that one image. What they did means, they got archaeologists, when they started to research, they went to one of the important place, that is Mohenjo-daro. When they went Mohenjo-daro, they saw, he got one of the evidence, that is water tank. They saw the water tank. So archaeologists, they return, this is not a water tank, this is bath tank. And this tank also, they built in burnt bricks. They used bricks. In that bricks in only, they constructed by water tank or bath tank. And not only this one, we can see in that in special features in bath tank or water tank. What was the features we can see here? Here they given one by one. In that water tank, here they say this is the two side, we can see the step. Just you have to see the image. Image they already given in page number 14. They already given the image. Just you have to see in two sides, we can see the steps. We can see the steps. And here they give a next one. And if one time they did bath in underground, they did seepage tank or seepage pipe. what was the water, the waste water, that one want to go outside. They use seepage system. And next year they say, sorry, what they did means, they did seepage system, they prevent seepage system, that like they say, means that is not leaking. We cannot see the leakage of in that particular tank. Means just you have to imagine it. On that time, they knowing how we can store the water in one particular place. And in that image, just you have to see, two side we can see step. And next one, in other side, we can go down. And in all the surrounding of that one, bath surrounding area, we can see some small, small rooms. So why they built that one rooms, here they given, because of, here they given, after the bath, or any special people they came, they can use the rooms for the purpose of bath. And once if they finish the bath, that water want to go outside, no, they used in down underground in some of the pipes to want to go outside of the water. So these like of they built by tank, not only this one, and for supply purpose for also they built another one pipe, that one come for water, that one fill to the that one water tank. So these are the important points or important features we can see about the bath tank or water tank. And next year they given, and we can see not only this one, we means archaeologists, they went other places also. For example, here they given one by one, Kalibangan, Lothal and Mohenjo-daro, Alappa and Lothal. Here we can see some other constructions also. This and all, what they constructed, these are very systematic. If they built house, if they built drainage system, if they built road, anything, if they constructed, all are very systematically. So on this way, historians they return, this is not a normal civilization, this one is urbanized civilization, because what they made or what they did peoples, all are very systematically. So these are the important points about why Harappa civilization is called as a urbanized civilization. Okay, next class we can discuss about how stone planning of urban, this one, Harappa civilization, because I already told all are systematic means that one constructions of house also very systematically, you know. So how they constructed house. So these are the matters we are discussing in next session. Okay, thank you.